Hello everyone, today let us solve one HC Verma circuit problem using an interesting approach. This problem is given on page 200, problem number 39. It's an unsolved question. It requires us to find current through all branches in this circuit. Now let's look at this circuit. It contains 6 batteries and 3 resistors. Now, if you apply Kirchhoff's current law to it, it becomes quite lengthy due to current distribution at various branches. So there is an alternate way to solve this. Let's begin. We can easily see that circuit is broken in 3 loops, left, right, and middle. Let us label them. This is our left loop. This is the middle loop. This is the right loop. Now forget about current distribution. Let us imagine independent currents passing through each loop. So for left loop, let us imagine that a current I1 is flowing through it. For middle loop, let us imagine current I2 flowing through it. Similarly, for the right loop, let us imagine current I3 flowing through it. Now, for sake of simplicity, I have taken all directions to be same, that is clockwise. But it's up to you. You can choose any direction, it won't make any difference to your final answer. Let us label the directions more clearly. All are clockwise. So let's show it with the help of arrows. Now, let us approach loop by loop. I'll begin with loop left, this one. So, left loop is drawn separately. To solve this problem, let us apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. KVL. I am using this sign convention for it. When voltage drops, we use negative sign. When voltage rises, we use a positive sign. And through a resistor, current flows from high to low potential. You can also apply reverse sign convention. Again, it won't make any difference to your answer because when we move in a loop, the net answer is zero. So let's get started. Left loop, we can choose any starting point. I choose to start from here. Let us do the labeling. Battery, positive, negative, positive, negative. Let us look at the current. Left loop, current I1 flows through battery like this. Again, current I1 flows through battery like this. First, draw these. Now come to resistor, this one. Here, I1 is flowing downwards. Over here, I2 is flowing upwards. So net current in downward direction will be I1 minus I2. And as I said, in a resistor, current flows from high to low potential. Since current is flowing downwards, this potential is high and this potential is low. Now let's begin with our starting point. We move from positive to negative terminal. Here, voltage is dropping, so we apply negative sign. This means negative 2. Here again, we go from positive to negative terminal. we apply a negative sign, and voltage is given by current times resistance. And finally, on this battery, we move from negative towards positive. So when V rises, sign is positive, we get a plus 2. And finally, we return to the starting point. Loop is completed, so net answer should remain 0. So in this equation, minus 2 plus 2 cancels out. We have only the middle term remaining. So if we solve this, we get this result. Current I1 equals I2. This becomes our equation 1. Now let's quickly move to middle loop. This one. Apply same process. Choose any starting point. Mark the terminals. Positive, negative. Positive, negative. Now look at the current. This thing. Middle loop. In this battery, current I2 flows towards right. In this battery, current I2 flows towards left. So first let's draw this. This thing and this thing. Now come to resistors, the right resistor. I2 flows downwards, I3 flows upwards. So net current downwards is I2 minus I3. Similarly for this resistor, let's check. Here, I2 flows upwards, I1 flows downwards. So net current upwards is what? I2 minus I1. Again, let's apply KVL to this loop. Starting point, we begin. This battery, from positive to negative, V is decreasing, so we have negative sign. This means minus 2. Here, current is flowing downwards. This means from high to low potential. Again, since V is decreasing, we have negative sign, which is given by current times resistance. Now come to this battery, we move from negative towards positive, V is increasing, this means we apply positive sign. Finally, this resistor, current flows from high to low potential, again V is decreasing, so we have negative sign. Current times resistance, loop gets completed, net answer is 0. Minus 2 plus 2 gets cancelled out. From first equation, we prove that I2 is equal to I1. So difference also becomes 0. Again, we are left with middle term only. This thing. So upon solving this, we get I2 equal to I3. Second equation. Now first of all, from first equation and second equation, we can say that first equation told us I1 equals I2. Second equation told us I2 equals I3. So we can say all three currents are equal. I1 equals I2 equals I3. Now finally, we move to the right loop. This one, the process remains same. This is my starting point. Positive, negative. Positive, negative. Let us look at the currents. This battery, I3 towards right. This battery, I3 towards left. The right resistor. I3 downwards. And this resistor, I3 upwards, I2 downwards. So net upward current becomes I3 minus I2. Current flowing downwards from high to low potential. Current flowing upwards, high to low potential. Apply KVL. This battery, we move like this. V is decreasing, so we use negative sign. This resistor, we move downwards. Again, V is decreasing, negative sign. And V is given by product of I and R. This battery, we move like this. Here V is increasing, so we use positive sign. And finally, this resistor, we move like this. Again, V is decreasing, negative sign. Product of current and resistance. Loop is completed. Net answer becomes 0. Minus 2 plus 2 gets cancelled. We know that all currents are equal. So difference of I3 minus I2 is 0. We are left with middle term only. This one. So from here we get I3 is 0. But we know that all currents are equal. So ultimately all currents are 0. So we can say that through all the branches, no current flows. So that's it. A clear and concise way of arriving at the solution. I hope you found this content to be informative. For more such concepts, please subscribe to our channel and keep learning. Bye-bye.